Hello everybody, welcome to Word Shard.
Hello everybody, so today I am back with Act 3 Scene 2, the rest of the part that was left. I had asked you a question from the last part, from the last portion, or the first portion of Act 3 Scene 2. The question was, why didn't Bassanio choose the silver casket? There was two marks, and many of you have answered. I will call out the name of Raman Mahadevan Keshri. Okay, he has answered it very nicely. Bassanio did not choose the silver casket because he thinks that silver is common drudge between men, because coins were usually made up of silver, and during the Elizabethan period, it would be good if you mentioned that line. And men fight and also compete among one another to earn more silver. Main point is that he, whatever you have written is correct, Raman. Just the thing is that you mentioned that in Elizabethan period, the coins were made of silver, and that is why silver was a metal over which people used to fight, and they used to, there was a common grudge between one another. That was the reason for which he did not choose the silver casket. Wherever there is fight, there is hatred, there is enmity, love cannot be related to that, isn't it? So next, pirated gamer, I don't know your name, you have not written it. It is better if you write your name, because what happens is that I can call your name. Otherwise, it seems very strange, isn't it, pirated gamer? So the answer is, silver was the metal of exchange. Yes, he has also written it correctly. You have written correctly. Between man and man, because the common coins were made out of it in Shakespeare time, you have mentioned it. It serves for business transaction, and so it is a common cross thing. So you've written all the points. Whatever points I have told you in the first part is correct, and your answer is perfect. Next, SK17, I also do not know your name, so you write your, mention your name like Tanisha does, right? After the answer, write down the name below it, okay? Or at least once you write it, so that I can, I know who you are, okay? The last part is, so SK17, your answer, you have also tried writing it correctly, you missed one or two points, so just be careful with that and it will be fine. That silver is a medium for men for exchange of money. It is a common grudge between men. So this is important. Other than that, also write that Elizabethan period portion. Okay. Otherwise, it is correct. So now let's move to Act 3, Scene 2, the last portion of it. I have tried to explain it to you as easily as possible. If you have any doubt, you know who to write to, isn't it? You'll write it in the comment section. And you'll also have the question at the end, or pinned to the comment section. So write down as fast as possible. Try and answer it. I think all those questions that I give in the comment section are very easy. Over that, after that, if you feel that there are other questions that you want to ask me from your workbooks, any workbook that you have, you can write that also, write in the comment section, okay, with your name. Okay, let's start with the scene.
So let's start with Act 3, Scene 2, and we are going to do the second part of it. The first part of the video you will find in my channel, and you will also find the link attached to this video somewhere above. Okay, so let's begin. Bassanio, you remember what had happened just before this. Bassanio had come to choose the casket, and somehow he has chosen the correct casket, because first of all, he thinks that whatever shines or glitters may not be the right thing. So he did not choose the golden casket. He also does not choose the silver casket because he thinks that, you know, silver coins were made out of silver at those times, at the Elizabethan times. And so he thought that coins are something for which people fight with one another, isn't it, to gain the money. That is why in a silver casket, Portia's picture cannot be. So finally, he comes to the lead casket, and he thinks that the lead casket appears dull, but it is offering the true self of itself. Okay, it is showing whatever it truly is. So that is better to choose than the other two. That is why he chooses the lead casket. Now see what happens, what he sees within the casket. Bassanio, what find I here, opening the leaden casket? So he opens the lead casket. What does he see? Fair Portia's counterfeit. Fair Portia's counterfeit means fair Portia's picture. What demigod? Demigod over here represents the artist who has drawn that beautiful portrait of Portia. hath come so near creation. So he says he is amazed looking at the beautiful picture of Portia. He says that, my goodness, this picture is painted so beautifully. I don't know which famous artist has painted this. He's somewhat like a heavenly being who could create such a beautiful picture. Move these eyes. So when you see a beautiful picture, you will see it appears that the eyes are moving with your eyeballs. When you look to the left, it seems that the picture's eyes are also moving to the left, as if it is moving the way you are looking. Okay, so the eyeball seems to move. Or whether riding on the balls means eyeballs of mine, seem they in motion? Then he questions himself, is it so beautifully drawn? Is it so lifelike that it seems that the eyeballs are moving? Or is it that because I am looking this way and that way, my eyeballs are moving? That is why it is appearing that the eyeballs of the picture are also moving. Is it that? Okay. Next, seem they in motion? Here are severed lips. Now we come to the lips. Eyes are done. Now we come to the lips. Now lips, you see in this picture also, you will see the upper lip and the lower lip is a bit apart from one another, away from one another. You can see the teeth, that is why, isn't it? So that means severed lips. That means the lips are parted. They're not touching one another. Parted with sugar breath. It seems that the beautiful picture of Portia, she is breathing. She is very lifelike. The picture is very lifelike, very realistic picture. And it seems that she is breathing and the breathe is coming out of her mouth. So it seems that she is breathing sweet breath through her mouth. So sweet a bar should sunder such sweet friends. So he says that you see the upper lip and the lower lip are like very sweet friends. And because they are parted, they are divided. That is why it seems that they are dividing the upper lip and the lower lip, which are very good friends. That means they're very beautiful. Here in her hairs, the painter plays the spider and hath woven a golden mesh to entrap the hearts of men faster than gnats. Gnats means little flies in cobwebs. Now he draws a comparison. He says that when you see a spider web, you see, na, they are so beautifully made, symmetrically and beautifully made. He compares the spider web, which is beautifully made, with the beauty of this hair. This hair, you see, they are entangled with one another, but they are very beautiful. Just like the way certain flies get caught into the spider web because they cannot protect themselves from that beautifully symmetrically made cobweb. In the same way, young men fall in the trap of this beautiful hair and the beauty of Portia, and they fall deeply and deeply in love with Portia. Now, but her eyes. But her eyes. How could he see to do them? He says that the picture is so beautiful. While painting, when he had painted one eye, when he had first painted one particular eye of Portia, then by looking at it, one would be so amazed that he would not be able to draw the other eye, because the first eye is so beautiful. When you look at that eye, you just forget everything and continue looking at that beautiful eye, isn't it? So Bassanio says that when the painter was painting this portrait, when he had drawn one eye, then he must have been very amazed looking at the beautiful eye that he had drawn. Then he could have forgotten to draw the second eye because he was so amazed by looking at the first eye he had drawn. So how could he stop from looking at the first eye and draw the second one? He's amazed. Having made one, methinks it should have power to still both his and live itself unfurnished. Unfurnished means that it seemed to Bassanio that this portrait is so beautiful. The first eye, one eye of this woman is so beautiful that after drawing that one eye, anybody would be mesmerized, would be so amazed, would be so... amazed, the right word would be amazed, so amazed by looking at that single eye that he would forget everything and leave the portrait, leave drawing the rest of the part and continue looking at that eye and leave the portrait unfurnished. But that has not happened. The painter has finished the portrait. So he feels, so Bassanio is surprised that how could he do that? Yet look how far the substance of my praise doth wrong this shadow. Now suddenly he thinks real Portia is standing in front of me and I am going on praising what? The shadow. The shadow of real Portia. A portrait is the shadow only, is not the real person, isn't it? In underprising it, so far this shadow doth limp behind the substance. So he says that, you see, this shadow, that means this portrait, is not so much as this real person. This person is much, much better than the portrait. And I am going on describing the beauty of the portrait, whereas the real woman is standing in front of me. Here's the scroll. Now you see, in every casket you have seen, when Morocco had chosen, when Aragon had chosen, they found a scroll inside the casket. Now what is the scroll in this casket? Let us read. The continent and summary of my fortune. Continent is a huge space, isn't it? So I have got a huge amount of things. That means I've got Portia, I've got so many things. I've got her love, I've got the money, I've got huge amount of things. So I am going to read what I have got. I'm going to read my fortune that is written in the scroll. Reads, you that choose not by view. So you are somebody who do not choose by seeing how it looks, isn't it? That is why he did not choose the gold casket. He is the one who is not fooled by the outward appearances. Chance is fair and choose as true. So that person has better luck and that person always chooses correctly. And that is why you have also chosen rightly and fortune falls to you. That is why you are fortunate. Be content. So be satisfied and seek no new wife. So be satisfied that you have won Portia and do not search for any other wife. If you be well pleased with this, that means if you are happy with this, if you are happy with the prize that you have won, that is Portia's hand, hold your fortune for your bliss, that means think that you are fortunate, and then turn you where your lady is, go to Portia and claim her with a loving kiss. With a loving kiss, you accept her as your wife. Now, a gentle scroll, fair lady, by your leave. So he is extremely amazed. This, after a loving kiss, the scroll finishes. The scroll has this much written on it. And now Bassanio continues saying, a gentle scroll, fair lady, by your leave, I come by note to give and receive. So this note, that means whatever is written in the scroll, that scroll allows me to give myself to you, to surrender myself to you with a kiss. Like one of two contending in a prize that thinks he hath done well in people's eyes. Now, carefully listen to this. This is a very beautiful comparison, but very easy. Just listen to it carefully, you'll be able to understand. He says that when you have won for example, if there was a competition and you were thinking that I wish I could win the prize, you are thinking, but then you perform and suddenly the judge calls your name that you are the first. You are victorious, you stand first in the competition. Now, you will have that kind of a feeling within you that, my goodness, is it true? Is it true that I have really won the competition? Is it true that all these people in the audience, they are clapping for me? My goodness, everybody claps for me. I have actually won the prize. So his state is also like that. He cannot believe himself that today he has won Portia's hand. He has become victorious. That is the relation between the two, the comparison. Hearing applause and universal shout, that means when people in the audience are shouting, clapping, they're happy for the person who has won the competition. Giddy in spirit. Giddy means confused. So the person who has won the prize, he seems confused listening to all those people clapping for him. Still gazing in doubt, he's still confused. He cannot believe himself that he has actually won the prize. Whether these pearls of praise be his or no, he cannot understand whether everybody who are clapping, they are clapping actually for him. So thrice, fair lady, stand I, even so, as doubtful whether what I see be true until confirmed, signed, ratified by you. Ratified means confirmed. So I also stand as that competitor who has suddenly won the prize. I am also very confused listening to this that I have actually won you. I could actually marry you. I'm so very happy, but I'm very much confused and I cannot believe myself unless you confirm me that I have actually won you. Okay. Portia. You see me, Lord Bassanio, where I stand. Such as I am, though for myself alone, I would not be ambitious in my wish. To wish myself much better, yet for you I would be trebled 20 times myself. So Portia says that, see, Lord Bassanio, what I am, where I stand means what I am. What I actually am, I'm going to tell you. Though for myself alone, I would not be ambitious. I don't want to be ambitious. I don't want to make myself much better than what I am now. But yet for you, I would be troubled. But to be equal to you, because you are such a good human being, you are so much better than me, I wish to better myself. I wish to be 3 times better than what I am, 20 times myself. And 1,000 times more fair, I want to make myself even more beautiful so that I can be a match to you. 10,000 times more rich, I also want to be even more richer, even more rich. And why does she want to do that? Because she wants to be equal to Bassanio. That only to stand high in your account. So she says that I want to make myself 3 times or trebled 20 times myself. I want to make myself much, much better so that I can equal you. What you are, I want to be equal to that. That is why I want to make myself. I am ambitious. I wish that I was even more beautiful. I was even more rich so that I could stand high in your account so that you can value me even more. Okay. Next, I might in virtue, beauties, livings, friends exceed account, but the full sum of me is sum of nothing. So you see, I have a lot of virtues, good qualities. I am beautiful. I have livings. That means I have a lot of money, possessions. I have friends. But the full sum of me, that means whatever I have, which to term in gross, that means grossly as an average, I am an unlessened girl. That means I am unschooled, unpracticed. That means I'm very inexperienced. I have a lot of money. I have a lot of good qualities. I'm beautiful. But you see, together, if you count, I am innocent. I'm inexperienced. Happy in this, she is not yet so old. But the good thing is, she is not very old, so she can still learn. Happier than this, she is not bred dull. So you see, she is not old. That means Portia is not old. Portia can learn. Portia has time to improve. Portia says she is also not dull. She is not stupid, that she'll not be able to learn anything even when somebody teaches him. Her. And happiest of all is that her gentle spirit commits itself to yours to be directed. So she says that the last thing is that I surrender myself to you, Bassanio. I want you to teach me so that I can make myself better. Done. As from her lord, her governor, her king, myself and what is mine to you and yours is now converted. So whatever is mine, I am giving it to you, and you will be my master, my lord. Next, but now I was the lord of this fair mansion. You see, I was the owner of this beautiful house. I was the master of the servants. I was the queen over myself. I controlled myself. But even now, that means from now, this house, these servants and myself, everything belongs to you, my lord. That means belongs to Bassanio. I'm surrendering everything, my money, my house, my servants, everything to you. And even myself to you. How does she do that? She gives Bassanio a ring. I give them with this ring. Okay. Now, there is a picture for you so that you can relate to it better. Portia gives Bassanio a ring. Now, which when you part from, lose or give away, let it presage. Presage means begin. So, if you give away this ring, if you lose the ring, if you some way give away the ring to somebody, then I will be able to identify it as the ruin of your love and my advantage to exclaim means to be angry on you. So if you lose the ring, if you give it to anybody else, I will take it that you do not love me. I will be angry on you and I will feel that your love for me is no longer the same. Okay, let's move to Bassanio. Madam, you have bereft me of all words. So I am so much amazed, I am so much happy that I cannot express myself. I am speechless. Only my blood speaks to you in my veins. So only my blood is speaking. My feelings are speaking for you, speaking for myself. But I have no words to express it. And there is such confusion in my powers as after some oration, oration means speech, fairly spoke by a beloved prince, there doth appear among the buzzing pleased multitude, where every something being blended together turns to a wild of nothing, save of joy, expressed and not expressed. Now, this is another example, comparison. Bassanio says that when a beloved prince, when somebody who is beloved to the audience, when he says, when he gives a speech, oration means a speech. When he gives a speech, people in the audience are very satisfied. The audience is extremely satisfied. They want to express their happiness. They want to give their greetings to their prince, beloved prince. But they do not have words to express it. Okay, so every something turns into a huge amount of nothing, isn't it? For example, if your favorite singer has come to the stage and sung a song for you, then there will be a huge number of people listening to the song, isn't it? So they are all happy after the song is when the song is over. So they all want to express their happiness. But what do you see? That there is a huge amount of scream from the audience. In reality, every single person in the crowd, they are trying to express themselves, their happiness. Okay, so my state is also the same. I want to express my happiness, but I am speechless. I do not have words for that. Okay, so but when this ring parts from this finger, so when you see that I do not have this finger, then parts life from hence. Then you can take it for granted that Bassanio is no longer alive. That means only when I am dead, the ring can be removed from my hand. But other than that, Bassanio is never going to lose or give away the ring. Or then be bold to say Bassanio is dead. Nerissa, my lord and lady, it is now our time that have stood by and seen our wishes prosper to cry good joy, my lord and lady. So see, Nerissa was always waiting when Bassanio would come, and Bassanio is the right person to marry Portia. So Nerissa is very happy that finally Portia has been given to somebody who actually loves Portia, and also Portia had a huge amount of feelings for Bassanio, so they both are satisfied, and Nerissa, as a very good friend, she is also very happy for them. Cristiano. My lord Bassanio and my gentle lady, I wish you all the joy that you can wish, for I'm sure you can wish none from me. And when your honors mean to solemnize the bargain of your faith, I do beseech you, even at that time I may be married too. So when Bassanio was choosing the casket for Portia, Cristiano was also trying his luck, and he was trying to, you know, woo somebody to marry. Who is that lady? That is Nerissa. So Graciano says that when you will be solemnizing your love, that means you will go to the church to marry, I also wish to marry at that same time. Bassanio, with all my heart, so thou canst get a wife. So Bassanio says that if you can get a wife, obviously you can marry when we marry. Graciano, I thank your lordship, you have got me one. So Graciano says that it is because of you that I have got a wife already. I have got a lover already. My eyes, my lord, can look as swift as yours. You saw the mistress, I beheld the maid. So I was also very fast in falling in love. When you fell in love with the mistress, when you were trying to choose the correct casket for the mistress, I fell in love with the maid. Okay. So that means Nerissa. You loved, I loved for intermission. No more pertains to me, my lord, than you. Your fortune stood upon the casket there, so did mine too. So you would be able to marry Portia or not, that depended on the casket. Even my chance of marrying the one I love depended on the casket. How? As the matter falls, for wooing here until I sweat again, and sweating until my roof was dry. So I went on pleading, making love vows that please, I do love you very much, I do love you very much. I went on saying this with oaths of love. At last, if promise last, I got a promise of this fair one here to have her love. So finally, I said so much, I promised so much, I vowed so much. Finally, the lady accepted. In which way did she accept? To have her love, provided that your fortune achieved her mistress. So the lady had said, the lady whom Graciano loves, she said that if Portia If Bassanio could choose the correct casket, only then Nerissa would give her hand to Graciano. Otherwise, not. Okay. Next, Portia. Is this true, Nerissa? Madam, it is so. You stand pleased with us. So, Portia asks Nerissa if it is true. And Nerissa says, yes, if it is all right for you, then I had made this promise and I will surely marry Graciano if you allow me. Bassanio, and do you, Graciano, mean good faith? Are your feelings for Nerissa true? Graciano, yes, faith, my lord. Bassanio, our feast shall be much honored in your marriage. So Bassanio says that I'll be very happy if we marry together. Graciano, we'll play with them, the first boy, for 1,000 ducats. So again, Graciano has started saying all those stupid things he always had. Graciano says that, okay, we will bet. I know that we will get the first boy. Nerissa, what, and stake down? So Nerissa says, okay, now you have started thinking of spending money again. Graciano, no, we shall never win at that sport and stake down. But who comes here? Lorenzo and his infidel. Infidel over here means the pagan girlfriend or the Jewish girlfriend of Lorenzo. So Lorenzo's girlfriend, who is that? That is Jessica. That is Shylock's daughter. So Lorenzo and Jessica comes. What? And my old Venetian friend Salerio. So you see three people enters the scene. First, Lorenzo, Jessica and Salerio, a messenger from Venice. Bassanio, Lorenzo and Salerio, welcome hither. Hither means here. You are welcome here. If that the youth of my new interest. Youth of my new interest means because Portia has just said that everything that is mine is yours, is Bassanio's. So Bassanio has gained something over here. Bassanio has gained this power to welcome his friends in somebody else's house. So he says that, see, my newly won position here gives me power to bid you welcome. By your leave, that means by the permission of Portia, I bid my very friends and countrymen welcome. That means I'm welcoming my friends in your house, Portia. Sweet Portia, welcome. Portia, so do I, my lord. So Portia also says that, yes, your friends are welcome over here. They are entirely welcome. Lorenzo, I thank your honor. For my part, my lord, my purpose was not to have seen you here. So Lorenzo says that I had no intention of coming over here, but I had to come. Why? But meeting with Salerio, that means when I met with Salerio, by the way, he did entreat me. He told me, he requested me, past all saying nay. So I could not say no to him. He requested constantly, and that is why I had to come with him along over here. So Salerio had requested Lorenzo to come with him, and so he has come. Salerio, I did, my lord, and I have reason for it. You see, I had some reason, I had some very serious reason, so I had to bring Lorenzo over here. Antonio commends him to you. So Antonio is the reason for which I have come over here. I have a letter from Antonio for you. That means for Bassanio. Gives Bassanio a letter. Now Bassanio starts reading the letter. No, before he reads, what does he say? Ere I open this letter, that means before I open this letter, I pray you tell me how my good friend doth. Tell me how Antonio is. Is he fit and fine? Salerio, not sick, my lord, unless it be in mind. So Salerio says that he is physically not sick. He is healthy physically, but his mind is sick. He is not mentally stable. Why? His letter there will show you his estate. If you read the letter, you'll be able to find out his situation. Graciano, Nerissa cheered yon stranger, that means welcome your stranger. So Nerissa, Graciano asks Nerissa to welcome Jessica inside with her welcome. Your hand, Salerio, what's the news from Venice? So Graciano asks Salerio that what is the news from Venice? How doth that royal merchant good Antonio? How is good Antonio? Is he fit and fine? I know he will be glad of our success. I know that Antonio will be very happy when he comes to know that we are successful over here. We are the Jasons. We have won the fleece. So this part you have to remember carefully. You have previously heard of Jason. So who is this person? You see, Jason was promised his inheritance if he fetched the golden fleece. What is the golden fleece? Golden fleece means the golden wool of a male sheep. Now, this is not just any ordinary wool. It had magical powers, and therefore Jason had to win that golden fleece. and it was seemingly impossible task. Nobody could get there. It was extremely difficult. After many adventures, Jason abstracted the finally Jason won the fleece, and with the help of media, with the help of another magician, that is media, like Jason's, Rusciano and Bassanio had come over here. It was a very difficult task to choose the correct casket, but finally they have been capable to choose the correct casket, and so they are victorious. Salerio, that is why he compares themselves to the Jason. Salerio, I would, that means I wish you had won the fleece that he had lost. So Salerio says that I wish you were successful in winning what Antonio has lost. Now, what actually Antonio has lost? Let's see. Portia says, what? There are some shrewd contents in yon same paper. That means there are certain things written in that paper which is very bad. Okay, some bad news must have come. Why? That steals the color from Bassanio's cheek. Bassanio's cheeks are becoming pale. Some dear friend dead, else nothing in the world could turn so much the constitution of a constant man. So as Bassanio read the letter that had come, he was turning pale. Okay, so Portia looks at him and says that something bad must have happened. He must have got a bad news. That is why his constitution is changing. What worse and worse would leave Bassanio? I'm half yourself and I must freely have the half of anything. So Portia says that because I'm your wife, I must get half of everything. So I must also get half of your worries. So that is why, please tell me what this same paper brings you. What are the bad news is written on this paper? Oh sweet Portia, here are a few of the unpleasantest words that ever blotted paper. That means here are the most, most unpleasant words that can be ever written on paper. Gentle lady, when I did first impart, when I expressed my love to you, I freely told you. So I told you at that time that all the wealth I had ran in my veins. I am noble, but in reality, I do not have any wealth. I do not have any money. I was a gentleman, and then I told you true. And yet, dear lady, rating myself at nothing, you shall see how much I was a braggart. So even when I said that I owned nothing, I had no money, I was bragging. Why? When I told you my state was nothing, I should then have told you that I was worse than nothing. For indeed, I have engaged myself to a dear friend, engaged my friend to his mere enemy to feed my means. So it is not just this that I am penniless, but it is this that I am even worse than that. Because for me, for my sake, so I have put my friend into danger. I have allowed my friend to borrow money from his enemy for my purpose. Okay. Here is a letter, lady. So you see, this is a letter. The paper as the body of my friend. It seems that this paper is like the body of my friend. And whatever is written on this paper is like a gaping wound, is like a wound, okay? Bleeding wound, issuing lifeblood. But is it true, Salerio? Now he asks Salerio, whatever is written on the paper is true or not? Have all his ventures failed? So Bassanio asks Salerio, if all the business ventures of Antonio has failed. So one is profitable. From Tripolis, from Mexico and England, from Lisbon, Barbary, India. So you see so many places. His ships had gone to so many places for business. But none of them was profitable. Bassanio could not believe this. Not one vessel escaped the dreadful touch of merchant mooring rocks. So it is very strange that all his ships met with shipwreck. And that is why all the ventures were lost. Okay, that means he was completely bankrupt, or he had not made any profit, so it is natural that he would go bankrupt. Salerio, not one, my lord. Besides, it should appear that if he had the present money to discharge the Jew, he would not take it. Never did I know a creature that did bear the shape of man, so keen and greedy to confound a man. So, you see, even if Antonio had that present amount of money to give it to discharge means to pay off the due of the Jew, okay, the due money of the Jew, he is not going to take it. And then Salerio goes on saying that this man, Shylock, has the shape of man, looks like a man, but so eager and greedy, and he is so so greedy to take what he had asked for in that pond that it seems that he is not actually a man. He is some kind of an animal who is revengeful. He plies the Duke at morning and at night. So he goes on requesting the Duke. He goes on forcing the Duke and doth impeach the freedom of the state if they deny him justice. So he goes on telling the Duke that if you don't allow me to have what is written on the bond, then it would go against the rules of Venice and then it would impact the business dealings, okay, the export and import, and that would be problematic. So he goes on scaring the Duke, he goes on threatening the Duke so that he could get the pound of flesh of Antonio. Now, so what is written next? Accusing 20 merchants, the Duke himself and the Magnificos of greatest port have all persuaded with him. So you see many important people, merchants, the Duke himself, the Magnificos, that means the highest ranked noble lords, everybody tried to persuade him, tried to mold his heart, but none can drive him from the envious plea of forfeiture. That means nobody can change his mind and he is completely bent on taking the penalty, that is the pound of flesh of Antonio. And his bond, Jessica, when I was with him, I have heard him swear to Tubal and to Cus. Tubal and Cus are the two people who are also Jewish and are friends of Shylock. So Jessica says that I have heard my father telling the other two Jewish people that he would rather have Antonio's flesh than 20 times the value of the sum that he did owe him. So he does not want the 3,000 ducats that he had taken from, that he had given to Antonio. Now what he wants is Antonio's flesh. Even if somebody gives him 20 times the money, he is not going to take that money. He is ready to take only Antonio's flesh. And I know, my lord, if law, authority and power deny not, it will go hard with poor Antonio. So he says that if legally Shylock is not checked, if Shylock is not stopped, then it would be a problem, because then it would be very difficult to change Shylock's mind, and he is surely going to take the pound of flesh from Antonio. What had happened? When Bassanio was in Belmont, Antonio had come to know that his ships did not reach the port, and therefore what had happened? He had become bankrupt. He is unable to pay Shylock's money. Shylock's that period of time, the 3 months period of time is over now. And the problem is, as Antonio is unable to pay the money within 3 months, he has to pay a pound of flesh from his body, as was written in the bond. Portia. Is it your dear friend that is thus in trouble? So Portia asks that, is it your friend who is in trouble? Bassanio. The dearest friend to me, the kindest man, the best conditioned and unwearied spirit in doing curtsies, and one in whom the ancient Roman honor more appears than any that draws breath in Italy. So Bassanio explains his friend. Bassanio says that he is a very dear friend of mine. He is a very kind man. He is best conditioned and unwearied. That means he is a very courteous man who does curtsies, who tries to help everybody. One in whom the ancient Roman honor most appears. Who appears to be the most honorable man in Italy? Portia. What sum owes he, the Jew? Bassanio. For me, 3,000 ducats. So Portia asks how much money he had to pay. Bassanio answers that it is only 3,000 ducats. Portia. What? No more. Pay him 6,000. Deface the bond. Cancel the bond. Give him 6,000. You have money now. So you go give him the money and cancel the bond. Double 6,000. Treble it if required. So give 2 times the money of 6,000. Give 3 times the money of 6,000. Whatever amount is required, give it to him and save your friend. Before a friend of this description shall lose a hair through Bassanio's fault, first go with me to church and call me wife. So first you come with me to the church, marry me, and then you go and help your friend. And then away to Venice to your friend. Then you go to your friend. Just after marrying me, you immediately go to your friend, help him out. For never shall you lie by Portia's side with an unquiet soul. So you will be disturbed if you stay with me like this. You go and help your friend after marrying me, and you shall have gold to pay the petty debt 20 times over. You will have my money, so you will give that money, whatever he requires, the Jew, and save him. Save your friend. When it is paid, bring your true friend along. When you have paid the due, you bring your friend over here. My maid Nerissa and myself, meantime, will live as maids and widows. So they will live as maids. We will be living as maids and widows. We will live as unmarried women or people, women who have lost their husbands. We would stay like nuns, and till the time you come over here, we will be living like that. Come away, for you shall hence upon your wedding day. So let us go and marry. So four of them will be going to the church. Portia is going to marry Nerissa, and Portia is going to marry Bassanio. Bid your friends welcome, show a merry cheer. Since you are dear brought, I will love you dear, since I have got you after a long wait. I would be cherishing this moment, but let me hear the letter of your friend. But before that, I will want to hear the letter that your friend has written to you. Bassanio. Sweet Bassanio. Now he reads the letter. My ships have all miscarried. That means they have met with a shipwreck. My creditors grow cruel. That means from whoever Antonio had borrowed money, all those people are getting angry on him because he is unable to pay their money back. My estate is very low. Whatever money I have now is very, very low. My bond to the Jew is forfeit. That means I am unable to pay the Jew also. And since in paying it, it is impossible I should live. And if I have to pay the penalty, I have to pay a pound of flesh. And that way, maybe I will die. All debts are clear between you and I. So there is, he assures Bassanio that there is no debt between them, between both of them. There is, Bassanio had also taken a lot of money from Antonio. So Antonio says to Bassanio that you see, your dues are clear. Don't think that you have a debt for me, with me. If I might but see you at my death, notwithstanding, use your pleasure. So I have a last wish that I want to see you when I, just before my death. So if your love does not persuade you to come, let not my letter. So I have written this letter to request you to come to me before my death. Because if I have to give the penalty to Shylock, then I'll die. Because he's going to take a pound of flesh from my body. So if you feel, if you wish to come, only then you come. If my love, if your love for me does not force you to come, then you may not come. Portia, oh love, dispatch all business. So Portia says that immediately dispatch all business. Leave everything that you have. Be gone. Go immediately and save this man. Bassanio, since I have your good leave to go away, since you're allowing me to go, I will make haste. So I'll hurry. But till I come again, till I come again, no bed shall ever be guilty of my stay. So I'll not waste any time. No rest be interposer betwixt us twain. Twain means two. He says that whatever happens, I will not waste even a moment. I will go immediately to Antonio, save him and come back with him. And I do not waste any moment in between this. Okay. So over here, we come to an end with Act 3, Scene 2. You see, it is a big scene and a very important scene. And that is why I have tried to divide it in only two parts so that you get it at your hand. And I hope this will be very easy because I've explained it in great detail. If you have doubt anywhere, you can ask me. Feel free to ask me. There are many of your friends who write to me in the comment section. Don't worry. Just write it down. Okay? I'll help you to answer the questions. If you have doubts, you can ask it. If you have doubts from any other scenes, that also you can ask me. And listen to the video while you follow your book, your textbook. And ask me if you cannot answer the questions from the workbook. I will request you not to follow any guidebook. If you follow these for explanation and if you write down the questions from the, practice the questions from the workbook, it would be very easy for you to crack the ICC exam. Okay, so I hope you have liked my video. If you have liked it, the same thing that I go on saying, please comment, subscribe and share because it helps me to grow, isn't it? So bye bye.